In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can do personalization with the help of Google Tag Manager. So we can hide, show, or replace elements on the website all through JavaScript and based on the user who is actually visiting our website at the moment. All and more coming up. Hey there, welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian and today we want to talk about personalization with the help of Google Tag Manager. Now you might have encountered personalization, especially when you log into a website and suddenly the website is personalized to you, so they know your name and it seems like the website knows who is in front of the computer. Now we can do all of these changes with the help of Google Tag Manager as well. In a previous video, I showed you how you can pull data from ActiveCampaign into Google Tag Manager so you have the user profile available in the data layer. Now that data can be used to personalize the website. What do we need for this? All in all, we need to have a little bit of knowledge, a little bit of skill of JavaScript CSS, but then also the data available inside of the data layer or inside of Google Tag Manager, so we have the means to actually do decision making and manipulate the website based on our preferences and the personalization of the user. Now this by no means the best practice here, because for personalization there's normally software out there that does this way better than Google Tag Manager, but I'm here to also show you the capabilities of the tool, and in some instances it might be useful for you. So without further ado, let's dive in. To get started with personalization, you need to have some data available that comes from the user who's accessing the website at the moment. Now such data could be available inside of a cookie, it could be available inside of JavaScript, if it's pushed, for example, into a variable, or it could be provided by the system if the user is logged in at the moment. Now, all of that information needs to find its way somehow to Google Tag Manager. We have different methods available to pull data out of cookies, for example, but the most reliable way and the standard way of having data inside of Google Tag Manager is the data layer. Now, I have a data layer right here. We go over to data layer, we can see the information that is available right now on this page for this user. Again, how do you get it there? There are different methods. Most of the time you would ask your developer to send that information over after the user has been identified in some way. I've done a previous video on how to pull such data from an ActiveCampaign contact into your Google Tag Manager account, so you then be able to use it for personalization. Now let's take a look what we have available here. We have the username, the first name, the last name, the email address, the lifetime value of the user, what he's interested in, what he has bought previously. We have the last login information, the last buy information, last visitor information, the last source he came from, and then the first source when he first entered our website, and if he's a newsletter subscriber. Now that is information that I've decided to push into the data layer. Depending on your CRM system, on your backend system, what data you have available about the user, you can push that into the data layer and then use it for your personalization. So what can we do with this data now? Let's take a look at this page. We have a newsletter field here, and let's start out with something pretty easy. We want to replace this hi there, make it more personal, and change the text around. Now, in order to do any kind of personalization, you will need to have the skills of selecting an element within JavaScript. So you also need to know a little bit about CSS, and then you need to know some standard DOM manipulation methods to replace text. In this case, we can try this all out in the developer tools. Let's click on inspect here and see how this is marked up. We have a widget title here in the ID Ninja Forms widget 2. I'm going to copy this and go over to my console. If that's not open for you, just press the escape key. It will open up down here. And we can select the element with document.querySelector. And in parentheses, we can put in our CSS selector. In our case, that would be the ID Ninja Forms widget 2. And then we want to traverse the DOM to the next node here, which is the span element of the class widget title. Let's press enter and we can see that this is the right element that we have selected. If I go down here and hover over it, I can see
This is exactly the element that I want to manipulate. Now I want to get the text of this element, which can be done with the command text content. And we have here our string hi there. And now I can manipulate it just with the equal sign and put in anything I want. And you see the text changes. Now, how can we use this command inside of Google Tag Manager? I have come up with a little example here. We want to change the text. So here's our first example. And it really uses the same line of code here. Only difference is that here I use a variable, a data layer variable that gets pulled out directly from our data layer information right here into a variable, which I've already built, which is called DLV first name, and it pulls out the information from our data layer. And that is information that I will use inside of our custom HTML tag. I come up with a variable, put in a string hi, plus the first name, plus exclamation point, and then I run my command and the text will be set to the replacement text that I've entered here. Doesn't seem to be right. Should be text content. All right, now we just need to attach a trigger. Now, which trigger do we choose? In our case, we need to wait because we are actually manipulating the DOM for the DOM to be ready and be loaded. So we can only use these commands, although the information is available beforehand, on the DOM ready. So we can make sure that all the HTML elements on this page have loaded and we can replace this text. So let's try this out. I have a DOM ready trigger already prepared. Let's save this and refresh our page. And we see here, there's a hi John now implemented. If you had a different name, this would be different. And as easy as that, you can replace text or change text around based on the information that you have in the data layer. Now, another field that I see here is the your email field. We wanna make it a little bit easier on the user and fill that out automatically as we have the information again in the data layer and the email field. So I've built a variable that is DLV email and it pulls out from the data layer this value. Let's try this out. I have already something prepared, the prefill tag right here. And again, it gets the element and then fills in the value with the DLV email. Really just one line right here. I'm gonna fire this on DOM ready. Let's save this and try this out. And voila, now it's pre-filled the form field so the user doesn't have to type in his email address anymore if he is not yet signed up to the newsletter. Now I've been using the information from the data layer inside of our tags to do some personalization, but we can also use that data to utilize our variables in triggers. And let's look into the data again that we have available about this user. And we see here, he is already a newsletter subscriber. He came through email the last time. So why are we even showing this widget right here? Couldn't we just remove it or hide it? Again, that's pretty easily done with a JavaScript command. I've already prepared something here, which simply selects our NinjaForms widget and then changes the style to display none, which is in CSS the way to hide an element. Let's try this out, but let's build our specific trigger that only fires if our user is already a newsletter subscriber. Let's create a new trigger. Again, this will fire on DOM ready. So the element needs to be there so we can hide it. And then you choose DOM ready as the event and only fire it when our DLV subscriber, which I've pre-built previously. So if we look into the variables here, we see subscriber is true equals true. Only then we want to hide the element. Let's save this and try this out. So we have our hide element and it hid our newsletter subscriber field because we know the user is already subscribed. So as you can see, you can use the data layer information, the personalization information inside of triggers as well to fire certain tags that change your website. Now let's look again into the data layer and see what information we have available. apparently it's a high value customer, already spent $500 in our store. He bought certain products, but what he didn't buy yet is a new special product that we have on sale right now. So we should make the user somehow aware of our sale that's going on. How about we replace our newsletter field with a banner? Well, I have already prepared something. If we go over to the personalization for replace, you can find here a little bit of code that actually creates a div element with the class of add and inserts a new image, which I've previously have uploaded. So you need to have your assets like images uploaded to your server, and then you reference that in your HTML code and insert this whole thing into the widget area. Let's try this out. We go over to the triggers and we're going to build a new DOM trigger, which will fire on if the user hasn't bought the product that is on sale. Okay, let's go over and click on DOM ready. And we only want to show this if the user, and we don't have yet a data layer variable for our bought products array here. So I'm going to create that. I'm going to choose a new variable and we're going to build a data layer variable for our bought products. Choose the data layer variable and I'm going to put that in here so it pulls out the right values. And if this bought product array does not contain our sale product, we want to fire our tag. Let's try this out. Let's save this. Refresh our preview in debug mode and refresh our page. And right now we see it has been replaced or appended to our widget area, a banner here that shows our sale product right now and a little banner that I've created. So we have customized the website to show a banner to the user when he enters and the information is available based on his previously bought products. Now, banners might not be your thing or it doesn't really compute on your website, but there are other ways to actually show people information that maybe doesn't change the website around per se, but actually displays something additional. And one of these methods is to actually show a hello bar that comes up from the top or a model window. Let's try this out. So I have a hello bar here. This actually works with jQuery. So I'm loading a jQuery bar here and a little bit of CSS and HTML. By the way, this is an example that I've taken from the guys at Lunar Metrics. I'm going to link up the source down below. And under the triggers, we'll just choose again, he hasn't bought our product yet. Let's save this. Refresh. Go back to our page. And you should see our promotion bar now opens up. You get a coupon code if you use the word ninja. Again, super simple personalization that only the user sees who hasn't bought the sale product yet. Again, the same thing we would be able to do with a model pop-up. So again, here is a bit more JavaScript that I'm loading, jQuery, also the jQuery model plugin. Then I have a little bit of HTML here and I'm calling the model. Let's try this out. Let's save this. Refresh our page. And here we can see we have, okay, this is a bit conflicting. Let's try this out again, maybe without the hello bar firing. Just gonna get rid of the trigger really quickly. Refresh this and this. And you can see our model pop-up now opens up. You could put text in it. I put the image in from our banner, but really anything would be possible right here. And you're not changing design around on the page itself, but actually adding something extra, which would be this model pop-up. Last but not least, we also have the ability to redirect the user if he has certain traits. So if you would see that the user just came from email, we might want to send him on to a special category that is for email subscribers. So again, we can use that information to invoke a redirect. So the user would see a little bit of the website before he would be redirected. So sometimes it's not the best method to actually use JavaScript redirects. Nonetheless, it's a form of personalization that I also wanted to show you. So we have here our redirect, and it's a simple JavaScript redirect where we send a user on to google.com. We could put in anything that we wanted to, like demoshop.com. So he will be redirected to the homepage, and gonna put in a trigger where, for example, again, we're gonna look into the data layer. In this case, we are not manipulating the DOM, so we could just use our user info event here. So instead of using the DOM ready event, we use the custom event, which is the user info event. And we want to fire this when our last source that we know the user came from, email, contains email or is email. Let's save this. Custom event last source email. Let's save that. Let's refresh this. And when I go to our page, reload that, the redirect will happen and I'm automatically sent to the homepage. Now, as you can see, we have a model pop-up going on here. That's because we have a demo running and it's not actual user data that comes in. Probably put in some kind of cookie so you prevent the pop-up from opening up again and again. But again, this is just a demo to show you the different ways of personalization. And we were automatically redirected to our demo shop. So here you have different methods of personalization with the help of Google Tag Manager. And I'm gonna make this available in a container download so you can upload it right to your Google Tag Manager account. You'll find the link down below.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can personalize your website with the help of Google Tag Manager and a little bit of CSS and JavaScript knowledge in order to insert these elements and do all these different tricks. Now again, this is by no means best practice. Normally you would have a dedicated website team that actually does changes that are visible to the user, and they might find it weird when suddenly something pops up in their browser and they don't know where it's coming from. Google Tag Manager is certainly capable of doing these changes, but it's not always best practice. So consult with your team before you actually do any of these changes with the help of JavaScript and Google Tag Manager. But I love to hear from you. Where would this be helpful? Where would you use such techniques? And also, do you have any other tricks on how you personalize the website based on the user's behavior, based on what you have in Google Tag Manager? Leave us a comment down below. And as always, if you like this video, give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to this channel because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.